All right, everyone, we are creating that water bottle pocket. So we are going to first create a border here. So it has a nice end finish on your bag. This is your main panel. Then we're gonna create the same border on the inside of the pocket, on the inside of the panel. And then we are gonna create the water bottle sleeve. Which is going to be a little bit different, but as easy to create. So let's get started. So the first thing we're going to do is we got to create that border. And to do that, we are going to measure 3/4 inch from the top and draw a line. And then I'm going to, once I do that, I've actually already done it, but if you want to see how to do that, you take your 3/4 inch on your ruler, which is right there. I don't know if you can see it, and then you're just going to measure it and you are going to draw your line. Then I like to use tape, it's just so much easier. It holds everything in place. You don't need to worry about, especially if you're using, I wouldn't use it if I had a thin fabric, but my fabric always bounces back because it's nice and thick. It's a waterproof fabric, for those that don't know, and it is an outdoor fabric, so extremely durable, easy to clean, easy to maintain. So then you're going to fold. See how I'm doing that? You're going to fold right up to the line, and that basically creates a clean edge. As you can see, you've got a clean edge. And now we're not going to just sew it like that. We want it much nicer. So we're going to fold it over again, but we're going to measure 1.5 inch. Because on the inside of the bag, I always like to have a thinner border and not as thick as the outside of the bag. So you're going to take your ruler. You're going to measure. I have a 2-inch ruler here. I'm going to measure 1.5 inch. I'm going to draw my line. And then I am going to, again, put some tape that's going to help me keep everything in place. And then we are going to fold this over again, right at the line. You don't want to see the line. So you see how I folded right at the line, but I don't see it because you don't want those details in the bag. You want to make sure that it's nice and clean. So you hide it, but don't go past it, and make sure that your border is nice and clean. So we're gonna do this on the panel, which is right here. We're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna draw 3/4 inch. We are going to tape it and then fold it. And then instead of measuring, what you call it, instead of measuring 2 inches after the 1/4 inch, we're gonna, 1.5 inch, we're gonna measure 2 inches. So I actually already did it here, but just so you can see, right, you're gonna measure your 3/4 inch, draw a line, you're then going to fold it, right? And then from here, once you folded it, you're gonna take your ruler and you are going to draw a line at 2 inch. And then from that, you are going to fold the edge to your 2 inch and create that border. And then we're going to sew that. You can use the tape. I didn't do it this time. I'm just showing you because I actually already created it. And I didn't want to undo it, just to show you. So that these are the two borders. One is 1.5 inch. The other one is 2 inch because that's my outside panel. This is my inside, which is going to be placed right here. And now we got to create our water bottle pocket with the pleats. This is the part we're going to be creating right here. So to do that, we are going to do the same thing. We love the tape. We're going to take the tape and we're going to put it right at the edge. Or if you don't want to use tape, you don't have to. But again, it makes life so much easier. And then you are going to measure 3/4 inch. I've always measured 3/4 inch for that nice fold. It just makes it much easier to do so. So from that 3/4 inch, you are then going to fold. Did I do more than 3/4 inch? I did do more than 3/4 of an inch. So if you do that, I recommend you actually put the tape back on, because or else it's so annoying. Your ruler sticks to it and it's a nightmare. Okay, so we are going to go 3/4 of an inch. And the reason I did that, because I don't like using this ruler. I like using this ruler because it's easier to see where my 3/4 of an inch is. Although it's running out. Alright, so there is my 3/4 of an inch. So I do that. I'm going to remove the tape. And then I'm going to do my border. And by the way, don't mind my finger that looks a little weird. I actually closed the car door on it. It did not feel good, let me tell you. It hurts so much. And now it doesn't hurt, but it looks awful. So I'm sorry, it's not a cute thing in the video. So from here, we are actually gonna measure 2.5 inches. And so from the top, I'm gonna measure 2.5 inches, and I am going to do that. And then I am gonna fold this in half because I wanna find the center of it, and it's easier if I do it this way. And I'm gonna mark it at one end and then mark it here, and then I'm going to draw a line. Give me the half. And this doesn't matter if you write all over the back of this, because we're not gonna see it, that's on the inside. And now we are going to apply the elastic. Now, I don't like cutting the elastic because you eventually pull the elastic to get a nice resistance. And then it's just a waste, because if I cut it right now and I'm gonna pull, I'm gonna lose about this much, and why waste, right? So I'm in no rush to cut the elastic. So what I do is I actually fold, I put the elastic right at the edge, right here, you see? Yeah, so this is kind of my guide. And then I fold over, and because if I have it at that edge there, I know I'm not gonna be sewing on top of it, you see what I mean? And I sew, and I start clipping. So I clip the end here, because you don't want that to go. And then just make sure that when you're pushing this down, your elastic is not at the edge and it's nice and back. We'll just because you don't want to sew, you don't want to sew on it, because if you sew on it, then you're kind of screwed. So you are now going to clip the elastic. I can feel that the elastic is right at the edge and it's not where I'm going to sew. So I push it and then I clip it, right? And I do one more clip. 4 clips is probably about the right amount that you need. All right, so now we have this. The elastic is underneath. I still have it attached. I did not cut it because I don't want to waste it. You can cut it if you want, but don't waste it. Why waste it, right? And now we're going to go to the sewing machine. So follow me. I am going to move my phone. And look how convenient this is. And I am going to place you right here. All right, we are at the sewing machine. So now we are going to sew. Why not start with the elastic? This is the most complicated one. So again, I make sure that my elastic is nice in the corner. All right. And then I am make sure that I grab my 2 threads, and I'm gonna follow this line here. So that's my guide. So I have a nice clean stitch. So again, always go back. I'm not gonna stitch this down because it's on this end that I wanna do that. So again, follow this. You don't have to go fast. Go as slow as you want, as fast as you want. If you have good control of your sewing machine and you're used to it, then go ahead. I do spot checks to make sure the elastic is not there, because again, if you sew it, you'll see later. It's a big pain in the butt. All right, so, and once I get here, I do want to turn it. Okay, I'm gonna do something that you probably really shouldn't do. You should do it the other way, but it's easier for me because I don't want to put all this fabric here. So instead of going forward, I'm just going to reverse stitch and then go forward. It's not that you can't do it, it's just, you know, whatever. Probably easier, people would do it the other way, but you know, everybody's different. So now you can take all this out. The elastic is nice and secure. Now we've got to create the pleats. So remember how we drew this line right here? We are now going to fold it and create that pleat. It's right in the middle. And do that. It's easier if you flip it and then go. Again, always use your guide, this part of the foot, to guide you to make your stitch nice and clean. And you know, attention to detail. Don't go too fast. Make sure it's nice and clean. Backstitch so your stitch doesn't go away. And here we go. So you're gonna go, you don't wanna go on the elastic, so you're gonna stop right before it and you're gonna backstitch. All right, and then make nice and tight. And then you have a great pair of scissors. I actually just got these from the Guggenheim. It's a Guggenheim brand. I don't know if you could see it, but they're really cool, really sharp, and work really well. So this is my first pleat. I'm going to do my second. We are, again, we are not stitching this elastic. We are going to do that at the other step when we attach it to the panel. So you don't want to do that now, but you do want to create that pleat. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna create the pleat, just nice and matchy. And here, this is perfect. And here we go. We are going to, here it is. Backstitch and you are done. You cut the thread nice. I've got nice scissors, nice and sharp. You're gonna cut it. We're gonna cut the end here. And now this is your zipper. I mean, your, keep calling it zipper, your water bottle pocket, which we're going to set aside with the elastic. You're not cutting that yet. And we are going to sew the panel, but I already did that for you, so you go ahead and sew that. I'll show you how to do it on this one. It's the same concept. You are going to put your foot again right at the edge and you're going to go straight down, making sure you stay steady, back, secure that stitch, and then stay right on the line. Because you want to create a nice, clean, straight stitch. And trust me, even if you go a little bit to the side, you'll be able to see it. So make sure you pay attention to detail. Your customers will love it, and your brand will do much better. It's really about quality and craftsmanship. And the back and forth is the quality, because it's really gonna stay in place and not go anywhere. The worst thing is for a bag to come apart. So here you're going to backstitch again. You're going to follow the outer edge instead of, I mean, the inner edge. And this is what you would have done on the main panel. Alright. So here we are. All right, so now we're gonna put this together. So you've got your main panel, then you've got your little pocket that goes on the inside, and then you've got the water bottle pocket. So now I am moving you back here so I could show you how we're gonna handle this. You guys are so patient. I hope you subscribed in my channel. I'm new and I need all these subscriptions that you can get. So please help me out. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to put this together now, right? So we are going to match those corners. This is the back, remember, that goes inside the bag. So we are going to match these corners. And we are going to match it here at the corner here. Make sure that this one is matched as well. And don't worry, if you have a little bit extra fabric, as long as your corners match, you could always cut that fabric. Sometimes that happens. It's no big deal whatsoever. Right? Okay. So now you've got your pocket. It's just not sewn on the inside. We are now going to attach the water bottle pocket in the front. So to do that, it's the same idea. I like to take the side where it's ready. And you're going to clip that first. So you're going to, again, match the corners, right? Because you want to make sure that it's nice and clean and that it fits nice and it's not crooked. So you're going to lay it flat. Make sure that it is nice and flat and fits right at the edge. The other one. And this is just perfect. And then I'm going to match the other corner here. All right. And then I am going to go a little bit where the other one is, halfway up. But I'm not going to attach this because I got to pull the elastic. So now that we have this, right, it's ready to be sewn, and I'll show you how we finish this part at the sewing machine because we can't finish it here. So let's go sew this. So I'm taking you back again one more time. It's so fun. It keeps you entertained. All right. All right, cool. You guys are there. All right. So remember, we did not cut the elastic, so that's why this is super long, but that's okay because we're saving. So we are going to start with the one that's already sewn, the elastic, to the end. And we're going to the end. And again, always use your foot. You can remove that. To guide you right here, you want to back. So we want to make sure that holds in place. And you're going to follow through. Now make sure that all your fabrics are in line and they're not, they didn't get somehow. I mean, these clips are pretty good, but you never know. So just make sure, always double check your work, that it's nice and neat. Here's where the back pocket meets. So just go back and forth. You want to make sure that it's nice and secure. You're going to tug on it when you use the bag, so you don't want to have any issues. Better safe than sorry. And do the same thing here. All right, look how nice this looks. So now we are going to do this side. We are going to start by sewing. Or actually, I like to start by pulling my elastic now, because I'll show you why. All right, so now we're gonna pull the elastic. If you didn't sew it, then it's gonna glide, no problem. But it does take a little bit of maneuvering. So you're gonna pull, and this, you see, this is the reason why I do not cut the elastic before. Okay, this is about right. So this is how tight I want it. I don't want it too tight, but I do want it somewhat tight. So now I do like to sew this before I actually sew it on the panel, just because it just makes it easier. I mean, you could avoid doing that, but I don't know. I've had issues sometimes, so, you know, it doesn't take that much thread, and so I do it. Okay, so now you are pretty much ready. You can actually cut this off because your elastic is now nice and secure. So you're finally done with that long elastic. And we are going to start from the bottom because you want to make sure you sew from here, that this corner, that the corner here is good. And then you're going to sew up. So you're going to flip it and you're going to start sewing from the bottom. Remember, backstitch and follow this line. All right. Make sure that all your fabrics are in line. They didn't shift. All right, when we get here, remember, back and forth, because you want to make sure that. All right. And here we are. You've got the zipper panel. So now it's just the finishing touch. You can adjust the elastic here as you like, because it's kind of, you know, either you want more elastic on this side and not less in the middle, whatever you want. And then here, you look how nice and clean this is. It makes it so pretty. I love it. We're gonna cut this so we don't get confused which what thread is what. And then here you're gonna finish it. You're gonna, again, always follow this. You're at, I forgot to mention, but you're at, I think it's like 1/8 of an inch when you're sewing this. And then when I actually put the bag together, I sew at 1/4 inch. All right, and here you are. You've got your panel. So you can adjust this as well. And you see, we didn't do this too tight, which is nice. So you can put your water bottle in it, right? And it looks like this pretty effect. And it's beautiful. It's on your panel. So what do you guys think? Was that easy? All right. If you have any questions, do reach out. Happy to help. But I hope you're happy and you've got a great water bottle panel. And shoot me an email. Send me a picture. I'd love to see it. Or tag me on your Instagram. All right. Bye.